Hello students, this is Dr. A.S. Iyer. Today we will discuss the third problem on the analysis of continuous beam using steepness matrix method. Highlight of today's problem is we'll discuss how to analyze the continuous beam if guided support is provided. Guided support is also called as slider. So, if slider support is provided, how to analyze the beam using stiffness matrix method, that we will discuss today in this class. So, the statement of problem is a continuous beam ABC is loaded as shown in figure. It has constant flexural rigidity. Constant flexural rigidity means EI is equal to constant. Constant flexural rigidity. So, flexural rigidity means EI. So, it has constant EI. Okay. Fixed support at A, roller support at B, and guided support at C. Analyze the beam using structure approach of stiffness matrix method. So, if you look at the beam, left support is fixed, middle support is roller, and end support at C is a guided support, which is also called as slider. Okay. The guided support means this support allows this point C, to move vertically up and down. Guided support allows the point to move vertically up and down. It means the kinematic unknown present at guided support is only one, and that is delta, vertical displacement. So delta C is the kinematic unknown present at guided support. Remember, guided support will not rotate. There will be no rotation at guided support. There will be only one kinematic unknown, and that is delta. Okay. Then at roller support, the kinematic unknown is again only one, but it is rotation. We know that. So theta b is a kinematic unknown at roller support, and at fixed support, there is no kinematic unknown. Kinematic unknowns are zero. We know that because fixed support don't have any translation or rotation. So, very first step in the solution of given problem is to find out degree of kinematic indeterminacy, and it is equal to 2 theta b and theta c, sorry, delta c, theta b and delta c, dki is equal to 2. Okay. Now, step number 2, now we have to find out the required matrices one by one, ad equal to adl plus k into d. This is compatibility condition, and now we have to find out ad, adl and k matrix one by one. So we know that AD will get from the original structure, action corresponding to unknown displacement in the original structure, that is AD matrix, action corresponding to unknown displacements. So unknown displacements are theta b and delta c. These are the unknown displacements. So corresponding actions means forces. Okay. So action corresponding to theta b is moment at B. If unknown is theta, corresponding action is moment. We know that. So if unknown is theta B, corresponding action is moment at B. And if unknown is delta C, means vertical displacement at C, corresponding action is vertical point load at C. So is there any vertical point load or force acting at point C in the original structure? No. There is no vertical reaction or vertical point load at C. So now, if you look at the original structure, is there any moment at point B given to you? No, there is no moment at point B in the original structure. So first element is zero. Similarly, if you look at the original structure, is there any vertical point load given at point C? Because action corresponding to vertical displacement is vertical point load or vertical reaction. So there is no vertical point load given at point C in the original structure. So second element is also equal to zero. So AD matrix is 0, 0. Now step number 2, now we have to find out the second vector involved in the compatibility condition, that is ADL vector. ADL stands for action corresponding to unknown displacement in the restrained structure. So we have to determine action corresponding to unknown displacements. So again we will see that unknown displacement is, first unknown displacement is theta B, corresponding action is moment at B. And second unknown is delta C, corresponding action is vertical reaction at C. So we have to find out RC. So we are interested to determine these two forces, moment at B and reaction at C, in the restrain structure, right? So we have to restrain the structure first. So restrain moments. So this is the figure. Now we know that for simplicity, we are drawing two members separately. We are restraining the support A, support B, as well as support C. Okay, so in AB member and BC member, all ends are fixed. Now we have to find out the restraint moments. It is central point load in first figure. First span, it is subjected to 40 kN and second span, it is 20 kN. Both the forces are centrally applied. So fixed-end moment, we know that the formula to calculate the fixed-end moment is WL by 8. In both the cases, it is WL by 8 because central point load. Left fixed-end moment is anti-clockwise, so it is positive. Right fixed-end moment is clockwise, so it is minus as per our sign conventions. So it is plus minus fixed-end moments. Okay. Now, one more thing. Now, in previous two problems, we have only rotations as unknown, theta B and theta C. So that's why we have calculated only moments, because moments are action corresponding to rotations. But in this problem, since our unknown is delta C, whenever unknown is delta, we need to find out reaction. So it's very important to understand our unknown, our requirement is to find out moment at B and reaction at C. So we have to find out reaction at C. It means now we will calculate the reactions of BC span in this problem. We are not interested to calculate the reactions at AB span. So this is not our objective. But we need to calculate the reactions of BC span because we required reaction at C, that is RC, which is action corresponding to delta C. Okay. So fixed-end moments are 40. WL by 8, 40 minus 40, then 20 minus 20. WL by 8, we have used the fixed-end formula. Now, reaction, how to calculate the reaction in BC span? Reaction is can be calculated in two parts. First, reaction due to external load plus reaction due to moment. Okay. So, reaction due to external load. So, external load is 20 kN center. So, reaction will be W by 2, W by 2, half of the load. So, it is 10 and 10. The external load is vertically downward, so reactions will be vertically upward. Both the reactions will be vertically upward because of external load. Okay. Now, reaction due to moments. So, to calculate the reaction due to moments, it's very simple. Reaction due to moments are equal to sum of moment at two ends. So, MBC plus MCB. Sum of moment at two ends. Please remember, here while adding these two moments, we have to take care of signs also. If moment is anti-clockwise, take plus. If moment is clockwise, take minus. So, reaction due to moment is equal to sum of moment divided by span. So, MBC plus MCB divided by L of BC. So, if you substitute the values, it will be equal to plus 20 MBC minus 20 MCB divided by 8. So, since plus 20 minus 20, the answer will be 0. It means there is no reaction because of moment. Okay, so there will be only reaction because of external load. It will be 10-10. So this is reaction calculation. Okay, we'll come to again our point now. What we need to calculate? ADL matrix. We need to calculate ADL matrix. So first unknown is theta B. Corresponding action is moment at B. And second unknown is delta C. Corresponding action is reaction at C. So what is the moment at B now? What is total moment at B? This is minus 40 and in second span it is plus 20. Right? So minus 40 plus 20, answer is minus 20. And then reaction at C. Reaction at C is vertically upward 10, so it is plus 10. Okay? So this is ADL matrix. Step number 4, we need to calculate the steepness matrix. That is K matrix, and we know that steepness matrix is derived by giving unit displacement 1 by 1. What are the kinematic unknown in this problem? There are two kinematic unknowns, theta B and delta C. So 1 by 1 we have to give the unit rotation at point B and unit vertical displacement at point C. So very first figure is when theta B equal to 1, give the unit positive rotation at point B, our first unknown. We are always giving the unknown displacement, unit unknown displacement in positive direction, remember. So theta b equal to 1, positive means we have to rotate joint b in anticlockwise sense. To rotate the joint b in anticlockwise sense, we have to apply moment at joint b in anticlockwise sense. So this is the moment applied in anticlockwise sense at joint b. This is anticlockwise moment. Okay, since joint b is common to ab and bc member, both the members will deflect. Both the members, AB as well as BC member, will deflect because B is a common joint. Now, what is the moment required to rotate a joint? It is 4 EA by L. Already we have discussed in previous two problems. 4 EA by L is the value of moment required to rotate a joint at far end. It will be 2 EA by L, half of that. Okay. So, 4 EA by L. L is equal to 8 meter for AB span. So 4 divided by 8, because EI is constant, 4 by 8, it is 0.5 EI. Half of that at other end, that is 2 EI by L. 2 EI by L, it is 0.25 EI. 2 by 8, this is 2 by 8, it is 0.25 EI. In the second span, again 4 by L. L is 8 meter again. So 0.5 EI, 4 by 8, and 2 by 8 is equal to 0.25 EI. Okay, these are the moments required to rotate joint B by unit rotation. Okay, we are rotating joint B in anticlockwise sense. That's why we are applying anticlockwise moment at B. And since we are applying anticlockwise moment B, it is same anticlockwise at even A and C also. So all moments are in anticlockwise sense. Now one more thing we need to calculate, and that is reaction. Since our unknown is delta C, one of the unknown is delta C, we are interested in reaction at C also, because action corresponding to delta C is reaction at C. C is a part of BC member, so we will find out reactions of only BC member. There is no need to calculate reactions of AB member. Okay. So BC member reactions. Reactions are in two parts. Reaction due to external load plus reaction due to moment. Now since we are dealing with the stiffness matrix, there is no external load acting on the B members. So only moments. Now, what is the reaction due to moment? Sum of moment divided by span. So, what is the sum of moment? 0.5 EI plus 0.25 EI. Okay, sum of moment at two ends of the beam. 0.5 EI plus 0.25 EI. Sum of moment divided by span. Span is equal to 8 meter. Now, since both the moments are anticlockwise in nature, both the moments will be positive. Okay, it is plus. So 0.5 EI plus 0.25 EI, 0.75 EI divided by 8, answer is 0.0937 EI. This is the value of reaction due to moments. Now understand, if this answer is positive, positive means it is anticlockwise. If positive means it is anticlockwise. So reaction couple will be clockwise, because reaction is of opposite nature of acting force. So if this is anticlockwise, the reaction couple must be clockwise. Clockwise means left reaction must be upward and right reaction must be downward. Look at this. Here it is upward reaction on the left support, downward reaction on the right support. It means it is a clockwise couple. Okay. How to calculate the reaction? I will repeat again. Sum of moment at two ends, 0.5 EI plus 0.25 EI. Sum of moment at two ends divided by span, that is 8. If answer is positive for this, positive means anticlockwise, and therefore reaction couple will be clockwise. So this is a clockwise, left upward, right downward. If this answer, if sum of moment is coming minus, in that case, the reaction couple will be anticlockwise. Anticlockwise means left downward, right upward. This is anticlockwise. Okay. So, according to this problem, this is clockwise reaction couple. This is upward and this one is downward. Okay. So, now since we know that our two unknowns are theta B and delta C. The action corresponding to theta B is moment at B. An action corresponding to delta C is reaction at C. So what is the moment at B? 0.5 EI plus this 0.5 EI, it is total 1 EI. And reaction at C is downward, it means minus 0.0937 EI. Okay, minus 0.0937 EI. This is first figure, theta B equal to 1. From this first figure, we will get the first column of stiffness matrix. We will get first column of stiffness matrix. Stiffness matrix will be of order 2 by 2. First column will be corresponding to theta B equal to 1 figure. And second column will be corresponding to delta C equal to 1 figure. Okay. First element will be corresponding to first unknown theta B. And second element is corresponding to second unknown, that is delta C. Action corresponding to theta B is moment at B. And action corresponding to delta C is a reaction at C. So in these two figures, we have to collect the action corresponding to unknowns like this. So this is your final K. This is your final K. Okay. So moment at B is 1 EI and reaction at C is minus this. Okay. This is first figure. Similarly, now second figure, delta C equal to 1. Okay. Delta C means vertical displacement at point C. So if you want to give vertical displacement, positive vertical displacement at point C, positive means vertically upward. This is positive. So we have to give vertically upward displacement at point C. Look at this. This is vertically upward displacement. Positive means. Okay. Now when you give the vertical displacement at point C, the beam member BC will deflect. But remember, there is no effect of this displacement at C on the AB member. AB member remains as it is. So there is no effect of displacement, vertical displacement at C on AB member. There is no moment on AB. Even there is no reaction on AB. Okay, so this is zero. Now what is the moment required to give the vertical displacement? Already we have discussed. The moment required to give the vertical displacement is 6 EI by L square. 6 EI by L square. So L is equal to 8 meter here. 8 meter L. 6 EI divided by 8 square. The answer is 0.0937 EI. The moment due to vertical displacement is same at two ends. Like in rotation case, when you rotate a joint, the far end moment will be half of that. But when you give the vertical displacement or perpendicular displacement to any point, the moment 6 EI by L square is same in magnitude as well as nature at two ends. So 6 EI by L square is same at B also. So its magnitude is 0.0937. Now if you have confusion to decide the nature of moment, what is the nature of moment, clockwise or anticlockwise? It's very simple to decide that. You draw one arrow in the direction of displacement. It is upward displacement. So draw one arrow in upward direction and bend that arrow outside the beam. So that you will get nature, it is clockwise moment. Clockwise moment is required at both ends. Moment is clockwise. Magnitude is 6 EI by L square. It is 0.0937 EI. Okay. So this is moment at two ends because of vertical displacement at C. Now finally we have to calculate the reactions due to moment because there is no external load. So reaction due to moment, sum of moment. This is 0.0937 and 0.0937 EI. So what is sum of moment? Both the moments are clockwise. So it is minus. So I will take EI outside. So it will be 0.0937 and minus 0.0937. So sum of moment at the ends of beam. Sum of moment divided by span 8. EI is outside. Okay. So this is value of reaction due to moment. Sum of moment divided by span. So answer is 0.0234 with the minus sign. Okay. This is the answer of reaction. Now what this minus sign indicates? This minus sign indicates that it is a clockwise. So if it is a clockwise, a reaction couple will be anticlockwise. Reaction couple will be anticlockwise if this answer is minus. Okay. So anticlockwise means left reaction must be downward and right reaction must be upward. This is the reaction direction. So look at this. This is downward here and this is upward here. Okay. Now remember, this minus sign is used to decide these directions only. Otherwise, there is no use of minus. Don't write down that minus here. Magnitude is always plus. Minus is just used to decide the direction or couple of the reaction. So this is minus means clockwise, and if this is clockwise, reaction couple will be anticlockwise, means this is downward, this is upward, it represents the anticlockwise. So this is left up downward, right upward is a anticlockwise reaction. So this is reaction calculation. Once you calculate this, now what is the moment at B? Finally, moment at B is equal to, it is 0 for AB member, it is 0, and here it is 0.0937. So it is 0.0937 EI, and since this moment is clockwise in nature, it is minus. It is minus because clockwise. And reaction at C, it is upward reaction, 0.0234 EI. It is 0.0234 EI upward reaction. This will give you second column of steepness matrix. So this is final steepness matrix. First column you will get from the first figure theta B equal to 1. Second column you will get from delta C equal to 1. First unknown is theta B, corresponding action is moment at B. Second unknown is delta C, corresponding action is reaction at C. So first element is represent the moment at B in two figures, and second element represent the reaction at C in two figures. Once you calculate this steepness matrix, finally equation of equilibrium or compatibility condition, AD equal to ADL plus K into D. If you put the value of AD vector, it is 0, 0. ADL from the restraint structure, just now we have derived the stiffness matrix, and two unknowns theta B and theta C, that is D vector. Two equation, two unknowns, you will get the values of unknown displacement. So theta B equal to minus 32.078 upon EI, and delta C equal to minus 555.8 upon EI. Once you calculate the displacement, this displacement can be used to find out finally moments. So moments can be calculated using the equation AM equal to AML plus AMD into D, where AM stands for vector of unknown moments in the beam. So since beam is having two span, AB and BC, two span beam, AB and BC, C is having guided support, B is a roller support, and A is a fixed support. So two span, so if span are two, number of moments will be four, that is MAB, BA, BC and CB. AB here, A to B, then B to A, then B to C and C to B. There are four moments. So these are the four unknown moments. Now AML stands for values of these four unknown moments in the restraint structure. Restraint structure, what is values of these four unknown moments? So if you look at our restraint structure, this is restraint structure. So what is the value of four moments? MAB equal to plus 40, MBA equal to minus 40, MBC equal to plus 20, and MCB equal to minus 20. Plus 40, minus 40, plus 20, minus 20. This is value of the moments in the restraint structure. Okay. These moments you have to consider in AML vector here. Look at this. It is 40, minus 40, plus 20, minus 20. Similarly, AMD matrix. AMD matrix you will get from the unit displacement figure. That is AMD. Number of columns in AMD matrix are equal to total kinematic unknowns or the unit displacement figures. AMD equal to, there are two columns in this because there are two unit displacement figure. First displacement figure is theta B equal to 1, and second displacement figure is delta C equal to 1. First column you will get from theta B equal to 1. Second column you will get from delta C equal to 1. So what this first column represent? First column represent value of four unknown moments. These four moments in the theta B equal to 1 figure. In the theta B equal to 1 figure. So if you look at the theta B equal to 1 figure, this one. So what is MAB, MBA, MAB in this figure? MBAB equal to 0.25 EI, anticlockwise positive. BA equal to 0.5 EI, anticlockwise positive. BC equal to 0.5 EI, anticlockwise positive. And CB equal to 0.25 EI, anticlockwise positive. So EI, if you take outside, the elements are 0.25, 0.5, 0.5, 0.25. All four are positive in the first column. Similarly, in delta C equal to 1 figure, similar moments you can write down. So this is 0.25, 0.5, 0.5, 0.25. And in delta C equal to 1, MAB 0, MBA equal to 0, MBC equal to clockwise, and MCB is also clockwise, so minus. And D vector represent your vector of unknowns which are known to now. Substitute that theta b value and delta c value. 1 upon ei is outside. This ei and this ei will get cancelled. If you multiply this matrix with this column, that is AMD into D, plus if you add one by one these four elements, you will get four moments. It's very simple matrix calculation. The moments are finally 31.98 anticlockwise, minus 56 and plus 56.04 at B, and 24.05. Remember, guided support is not a simple support, so there is moment at guided support. There is a moment at guided support. Okay, it's not like a simple support, moment is zero. Okay, finally you can plot the bending moment diagram on the guided support. So bending moment diagram can be plotted in two parts. First, simple moment A to B and B to C, there are two span. So simple moment means positive moment because of external load. External load is central point load, 40 kN and 20 kN. So 40 kN means it is a triangle. 20 kN central is also triangle. So this is WL by 4 maximum moment, WL by 4 in both the cases because central point load. Okay. W is equal to 40, L is equal to 8 divided by 4. So this moment will be 80. This moment will be 80. 40 into L is 8 divided by 4. And this moment WL by 4 is equal to 20 into 8 divided by 4, it will be 40. Okay, these are the simple moments. Then end moments, this is 31.98. Answer is positive, means anti-clockwise. Anti-clockwise moment. So you have to plot it above the line. This is 31.98. Okay, 31.98, and at point B, BA is minus, means clockwise, and BC is anti-clockwise. So its magnitude is 56. This is 56.04. And moment at C is 24.05. Positive means anti-clockwise. So anti-clockwise means it is downward. So this is 24.05. Okay. 24.05. So if you join all these lines with a straight line, this is your bending moment diagram. You can hash the net bending moment diagram. Okay. You can highlight the net bending moment diagram like this. This is your final bending moment diagram. Right. So with this solution of a continuous beam supported by a guided support using structure approach of stiffness matrix method is over. Okay. In the next class, we will take one problem of spring support. Analysis of continuous beam using structure approach of stiffness matrix method if a spring supported is provided in the structure. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.